Prince Harry and Meghan Markle have revealed eagerly awaited details of their wedding. The couple will wed on Saturday, May 19 at St. George's Chapel, Windsor Castle. That is the same day as the 2018 FA Cup final. The wedding service will begin at midday, meaning that a clash with the football is unlikely because recent FA Cup finals have kicked off at 5:30 p.m. St. George's Chapel at Windsor Castle, Berkshire, where Prince Harry and Meghan Markle will have their wedding service. Image, Dominic Lipinski, PA Wire. The Dean of Windsor will conduct the service and the Archbishop of Canterbury will officiate as the couple make their vows. At 1 p.m., the newlyweds will embark on a carriage procession along a route including Castle Hill, High Street, Sheet Street, King's Road, Albert Road, Long Walk and finally Windsor Castle. They hope this short journey will provide an opportunity for more people to come together around Windsor and to enjoy the atmosphere of this special day, the palace said. People enjoy the sunshine on the long walk at Windsor Castle in Berkshire. Image, Steve Parsons, PA. After the service, there will be a reception at St. George's Hall for the couple and guests from the congregation. Harry and Ms. Markle will join their guests at the reception when they return from the carriage procession. Later that evening, the Prince of Wales will give a private evening reception for the couple and their close friends and family. The palace said further details about the wedding day will be revealed in the weeks and months ahead. Timeline: Meghan and Harry's wedding timetable. The wedding service will begin at 12 noon at St. George's Chapel. The Dean of Windsor will conduct the service and the Archbishop of Canterbury will officiate as the couple make their vows at 1 p.m. The newlyweds will embark on a carriage procession along a route including Castle Hill, High Street, Sheet Street, King's Road, Albert Road, Long Walk and finally Windsor Castle. Kensington Palace said, they hope this short journey will provide an opportunity for more people to come together around Windsor and to enjoy the atmosphere of this special day. After the service, there will be a reception at St. George's Hall for the couple and guests from the congregation. Harry and Ms. Markle will join their guests at the reception when they return from the carriage procession later that evening. The Prince of Wales will give a private evening reception for the couple and their close friends and family. The royal family are paying for the wedding, including the church service, the music, the flowers, and the reception. But the security costs for the high-profile event are falling to the taxpayer. As president of the Football Association, Prince William usually attends the FA Cup final and presents the trophy. But this year, William, who is tipped to be Harry's best man, looks likely to be otherwise engaged with wedding duties. Image, Daniel Leal Olivas, PA Wire. Windsor Castle is less than 30 miles from Wembley Stadium and about an hour's drive, which would mean William would be away from the celebrations for a minimum of 2 hours if he did present the silverware. Prince William did joke about being best man, saying, "He hasn't asked me yet, it could be a sensitive issue." He also said he is still working on the date clash between the wedding and the football. A Saturday wedding. Harry and Ms. Markle have gone against tradition by choosing a Saturday, as royal weddings usually take place on a weekday. Prince William and Kate Middleton. Image, Kirsty Wigglesworth, WPA Pool. Getty Images. William and Kate Middleton, now the Duchess of Cambridge, married on a Friday and their service began at 11 a.m. Palace aides have already said that the Prince and Ms. Markle's wedding will reflect their characters and personalities and be a moment of fun and joy. The guests and bridesmaids, the Queen will be there, as will the rest of the royal family, along with Ms. Markle's parents Thomas Markle and Doria Ragland. Prince George and Princess Charlotte are likely to take on the roles of page boy and bridesmaid. He proposed to suit star Ms. Markle during a cozy night and over a roast chicken dinner after a 16-month whirlwind romance. In his engagement interview, he told of how the stars were aligned when he fell for his future wife, whom he met on a blind date. Meghan Markle's engagement ring. Ms. Markle has a trilogy ring and Kensington Palace said the prince designed it himself, using two stones which belonged to his late mother. The two outside stones are diamonds from the personal collection of Diana, Princess of Wales. Image, PA. At the center is a diamond from Botswana, a country that holds special significance for Harry, who has visited many times since he was a child. It is also a place the couple has spent time together over the last year and a half, Kensington Palace said. The band is made of yellow gold, and the ring was made by Cleve & Company, court jewelers and medalists to Her Majesty the Queen. Harry said, the ring is obviously yellow gold, because that is her favorite. Image, Chris Jackson, Getty Images. But how much did the engagement ring cost? Some reports suggest it could be anywhere between £25,000 and £200,000. Speaking to The Express, Grant Mobley, a gemologist and director at Plutchenik, said the ring could be worth around £122,500. He pulled the paper. From seeing the pictures, I would estimate that the center diamond is a slightly elongated cushion-cut diamond, approximately 3 to 4 carats. The side diamonds are more than likely oval or round-cut diamonds about 0.75 carats each. Meghan Markle's wedding ring. The use of Welsh gold in Meghan Markle's wedding ring would maintain a long royal tradition that was first created in 1923. Royal wedding rings are traditionally made from Welsh gold. Since the custom was started by the Queen Mother in 1923, Welsh gold has been used for royal brides ever since, and Meghan Markle could follow suit. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle in Cardiff. Image, Getty Images Europe. The Duchess of Cambridge's wedding ring, a plain, slim gold band, was made by royal warrant holders Wartsky and fashioned from a nugget of Welsh gold given to the Duke of Cambridge by his grandmother, the Queen, as a gift to mark his 2011 wedding. The Queen Mother's wedding ring, the Queen's in 1947, Princess Margaret's in 1960, the Princess Royal's in 1973, and that of Diana, Princess of Wales, in 1981 were all made from one nugget. The gold came from the Clogau St. David's Mine at Bontddu, Gwynedd. There is now only a minute's sliver, 1 gram, 0.035 ounces, of the original nugget left. But in November 1981, the British Royal Legion presented the Queen with a 36-gram, 1.3 ounces, piece of 21-carat Welsh gold for future royal wedding rings. Clogau gold. Image, Andrew James. The Duchess of Cornwall's wedding ring was also crafted from Welsh gold from the Clogau St. David's Mine in the River Modach in the King's Forest. It was handmade in court style by Wartsky, and the precious metal was supplied by Cambrian Goldfields Limited. Prince Harry's brother, William, chose not to wear a wedding ring. The Prince of Wales does wear a wedding band under a signet ring on the little finger of his left hand, but the Duke of Edinburgh does not. We'll have to wait and see what the couple selects.